Durbar Square still bears the traces of the earthquake of 2015. I like this atmosphere bordering on chaos, with its temple shored up by market ship supports. It reminds us of the impermanence of things, sometimes giving us the impression of living like ridiculous puppets, seeking an illusory balance each day in order to stand. Here is Eastern culture. There is no place for doubt. Faith is stronger than buildings. Buddha and Shiva welcome us to the afterlife. Kathmandu is a city with an incomparable atmosphere of the vibrant and colorful cities of the Orient. It remains a real pleasure to walk through these streets to meet Nepali people and their culture. Durbar Square, south of Tamil, in the center of Kathmandu, with a group of monuments classified World Heritage, was the site of the ancient royal city and has several Hindu temples dedicated to Shiva Vishnu, Krishna Ganesh, and Parvati. The temple of Kala Bhairava represents Shiva in a terrifying form. There is also the residence of the Kumari, incarnation of a Hindu goddess. Most of the buildings on Durbar Square were built between the 16th and 18th century, several times rebuilt after successive earthquakes. Kathmandu is a megalopolis where air pollution is all around us, and in every street I visit, I meet people, their face covered with anti-pollution masks. Pollution mixed with the dust of the street often causes my lungs to burn. A foretaste of the air we risk breathing in years to come on our planet. What remains of the beatniks on the path of Kathmandu? What remains of the memories of the journey to the heart of the Himalayas of Alexandra David-Néel? They have been replaced by alpinists queuing on Everest Boulevard. Excitement, fear and dependence remain the fuel of this deadly ideology of profit that is spreading like a virus all over the planet, a disease maintained by a liberalism. become a doctrine with no other moral action than that of money and power.